Hi everyone, Sherry from Granny's Sewing Room, stopping in to say hi and let you know what I'm working on. And I want to thank all my new subscribers. I said probably about four or five videos back that if I hit 500 subscribers, I want to do a giveaway. And that's what I want to do. I have 507 subscribers. Woohoo! Praise the Lord. So I just pray that God continues to let this channel grow and that He can do some mighty things through it. While I express my love for sewing, He can express His love for all of us. So that is my hope. Anyway, I did get some prayer requests, and one of them is pretty important, I think. A lady named Gail lost her husband, and if we could hold her up in prayer this week just for God's mighty love to be about her and to protect her and watch over her, that would be awesome. I did get another prayer request over the weekend, and this is for Sue. Just getting over COVID, and so she needs our prayers. And she also has a father that's 92 years old, and he doesn't know the Lord, and he doesn't want to know the Lord. So, but we know God is powerful. So let's hold Sue up in prayer for quick, speedy recovery, 100% recovery, and let's hold her up for her father. So he wants to come to know the Lord, and we know God doesn't wish for any to perish, but all of us to have everlasting life. So let's lift him up in prayer. I don't know his name, but that's okay. God does. So if we just move on their behalf, that would be awesome. So the way I'm going to do my giveaway, it's going to be a $25 Amazon gift certificate. So that way, if you don't want to sew, you want to buy a devotional book, you whatever you want to do with it, it's your choice. So after I get off of this video, I'm going to try to learn how to do that number generator. And I think you leave a comment. So let's, in the comment, everybody that wants to get in the $25 giveaway, write, what's a good comment? Let's just do winner, W-I-N-N-E-R. So everybody, don't write anything but just winner. And I will do one of them, number generators. And I don't know how it works, so bear with me, but by Friday Sews, I should have it. I should know it. If I know it before then, I'll jump on and let the winner know. And I will notify the winner, and then we can respond back to each other and figure out a way to get that $25 Amazon gift card to you. So you could maybe buy an indie pattern. That's what's on my cutting board. The pattern I wanted to do, it needed more a stiffer knit to do the collar that I wanted to do. I'll post a picture of this top that I have on with the pattern number on it. But this is a pattern, Itch to Stitch, Arenal top. And I just got it over the weekend. And I will post a picture because I don't have a picture of it. But it has a top yoke to it. And I'm going to try to do some lace type of thing. And this is the fabric that I'm going to use with it. It calls for 100% stretch. I don't know how to judge for the stretch. So I think that's a lot of stretch, but the finish measurements, I'm a 42 and it says take your widest bust part, 42. And the finish measurements on a size 14, I think it said like a 40. And I'm thinking, ooh, that's going to be tight. So maybe a 16 where the finish measurement will be a 41. So that'll give some stretch. I don't want it too big here because it's a V-neck. But I don't want it too tight here so I look like Dolly Parton. So I think I'm going to go up one size, and that's where I have issues, really not knowing my size. But so far, doing the indie patterns that I've been doing, their fits are awesome, just awesome. So I bought a few of her patterns. This is the Itch to Stitch gal, and this is the Arenal top. I got a I think a hoodie or something that I seen someone do, and I bought that, but I don't know how soon I'm going to get to that. But one of my next really big things that I want to do is find me some like yoga pants. I don't want straight legs. I'm not into the straight legs. Just something with a yoga band and black pants that I can have a few pair and throw on with any top that I make and wear around the house. But that's one, a good fit. So if you know one that's a good fit and I want it to be an indie pattern, I don't want to have to use any of the big four patterns, the envelope patterns that I have all over. I'm going to try to get to some painting this week. If not, I'm going to get a top done for sure. Has anyone told you you're special today? If not, let me be the first to tell you, because you are in God's eyes. And you know, you get on camera and you think you got it all down, and then all of a sudden, boom, you don't remember a thing you're supposed to be saying or you want to say. But one other thing that I wanted to say is, now if you have prayer requests, please leave them in the comment, and I do write them down. I pray for them weekly or daily, and then at the end of the week, I lift them all up in prayer. But that way other people could be praying for you throughout the week. So if you have a prayer request, please put it in the comments so all of us can kind of share and look and see. And even if we only lift one person up in prayer for that week, that's more prayers for that person. So, and another thing that I want my channel to start, and I, because when God flew that out of my mouth, I thought, oh my goodness. So I have really been thinking about this. My granddaughter got a card today and she was ecstatic about it. She was so happy to get a card from someone. And I want you to know that it works, you know, just a little card from a stranger, and that's all it is, just a card and a postage stamp. But I'm calling this a ministry of flood of love. We're going to flood people with love in cards. And how I want to do it is, if you leave an address and the name of the person, they can be in the hospital, they can be in jail, they can be just going through a very rough time in life, they could have lost their husband, or wife, or something, if we can flood them with love through a card. You leave the address, and every month I will take the very first address, and I will post that on my website or my YouTube video, and we'll have a whole month of people being able to jump on board for a whole month, just specifically sending cards to that person and showing, flooding them with love, flood of love. I just thought that was so awesome, the way God said that. But that is one of my goals for this YouTube channel. So next month, February 1st, if you leave a name and address and a little bit why, so we know why we're sending them a card, and so we can give them a little encouragement, a little of God's love, and we'll call it the Flood of Love, YouTube family's Flood of Love. And that's what, you know, sometimes we can't get out and do anything, but this is a simple way for us to connect and do God's work. So this isn't hard at all. So I'll leave that there. And so don't forget to leave your prayer request. Don't forget, if you have someone special you would like us to flood them with love, leave their name, address, and a little description of what we're flooding them with love for. And I will be back to show you my Itch to Stitch new pattern. I'm going to put a picture of it up. I picked out another one because my problem is picking out fabric to go with the pattern. So I might put up another picture that I was another choice of mine, and see if you guys, which ones you guys like before I cut out. Because I hate cutting out fabric if I don't know for sure if it's going to look good. But with this one, I found an old curtain. So this old curtain, I'm going to have it up here. I'm going to have the material under it, but this is going to be just part of the yoke here. Let me see if I can find it. Oh, I don't have that piece here. But this calls for a little yoke up here. And this part is separate, and you sew it onto the bounce here. And I'm going to make that a curtain I found, a little lace curtain. I would like it to be more of an embroidery, but I don't have any of that. And so I'm going to do that, put that on top of the material itself. and I'm going to make it quarter length. It's a V-neck, so I'll show a picture of this pattern and I'll show a picture of another pattern, because everybody's telling me about Ellie and Mac. I think it's Ellie and Mac. I found a pattern from her last night and I like that one too. So I'll show you both pictures. Here's the fabric. And you guys tell me what you think. Which one do you think would look as a better top with this? Here's the stretch of this. Long ways, not much. Around me. So I think that may be a 50% stretch, not 100%. I think the shirt I did last time was 100% stretch because it stretched out a whole lot. I got a lot of good tips on how to fix that neck band too, and my dress. Oh, I took my dress off. But I got a lot of good tips, so thank you guys very much. I read those, and I know why I'm saving them skinny little pieces of elastic that goes with your shoes now. Some lady gave me an awesome tip what to do with that. So I know why I save them. I look at them, I think, I can't throw that away. Something could be used with that. And she said she puts a little casing in the back of her her neck band, and she just adds that little bit of elastic that you get when you buy shoes and stuff, and it just kind of cinches the back of the neck up. And I thought, ooh, that's a kind of a neat thought, especially if your top's already made and you don't want to cut into it, make seams, or so. That was kind of a nice thought. So, but I will get off here. I know as soon as I end my video, I'm going to have a ton of things I want to tell you. So that will be it for today. But you guys go out and have a great day. We're having a snowstorm here. We can get up to 12 inches. So I'm hunkering down here in my sewing room. Gonna maybe get this cut out or wait and see what y'all think with the patterns that I show you, and maybe cut it out tomorrow. It's kind of a shame I can't see the beauty of the snow falling down here, so that's kind of a bummer. But all right, everybody, God bless, have a great day, and I'll see you soon to let you know who the winner is of the $25 Amazon gift card. And thank you very, very, very much for watching my channel, taking the time out to watch my channel and subscribing to my channel. I do appreciate it. And I'll tell you, if you watch my very first videos from now, this has really helped me get out of a depression that I was in. So this is benefiting me so tremendously. And you really don't know what it feels like to have people out there that gives you the sweetest compliments and kindest words, and knowing you have a prayer group there that you can ask for prayer, and people are lifting you up in prayer. So thanks, everyone. Bye. God bless.